Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about the 5 phases of ethical hacking. If you want to know what ethical hacking is, please watch our video, What is Ethical Hacking? So let's get started. Finding and fully exploiting system vulnerabilities takes a great deal of time and patience. A typical penetration testing requires the ethical hacker to bypass authorization and authentication mechanisms, then probe the network for potential data breaches and network security threats. As a real-world black hat hacker consistently devises new ways to exploit vulnerabilities, an effective ethical hack should be carefully thought out considering the changing threat landscape. To find such vulnerabilities, ethical hackers undertake several steps of the ethical hacking methodology. These steps of hacking include reconnaissance, scanning, gaining access, maintaining access, and clearing track. While not every hacker follows these steps in sequential order, they offer a systematic approach that yields better results. Let us take a closer look at what these hack phases really offer. When it comes to penetration testing, the first natural question to ask is, what is the first phase of hacking? Before performing any actual penetration tests, hackers footprint the system and gather as much information as they can. Reconnaissance is a preparatory phase where the hacker documents the organization's request, finds the system's valuable configuration and login information, and probes the networks. This information is crucial to performing the attacks and includes naming conventions, services on the network, servers handling workloads in the network, IP addresses, names and login credentials of users connected to the network, the physical location of a target machine. The ethical hacker begins testing the networks and machines to identify potential attack surfaces in this stage. This involves gathering information on all machines, users, and services within the network using automated scanning tools. Penetration testing typically undertakes 3 types of scans. Network mapping. This involves discovering the network topology, including host information, servers, routers, and firewalls within the host network. Once mapped, white hat hackers can visualize and strategize the next steps of the ethical hacking process. Port scanning. Ethical hackers use automated tools to identify any open ports on the network. This makes it an efficient mechanism to enumerate the services and live systems in a network and how to establish a connection with these components. Vulnerability scanning. The use of automated tools to detect weaknesses can be exploited to orchestrate attacks. While there are several tools available, here are a few popular ethical hacking tools commonly used during the scanning phase. SNMP sweepers, ping sweeps, network mappers, and vulnerability scanners. Once ethical hackers expose vulnerabilities through the first and second hacking phases of the process, they now attempt to exploit them for administrative access. The third phase involves attempting to send a malicious payload to the application through the network, an adjacent subnetwork, or physically using a connected computer. Hackers typically use a number of hacking tools and techniques to simulate attempted unauthorized access, including buffer overflows, phishing, injection attacks, XML external entity processing, using components with known vulnerabilities. If the attacks are successful, the hacker has control of the whole or part of the system and may simulate further attacks, such as data breaches and distributed denial of service. The fourth phase of the ethical hacking process involves ensuring the hacker can access the application for future use. A white hat hacker continuously exploits the system for other vulnerabilities and escalates privileges to understand how much control attackers can gain once they get past security clearance. Some attackers may also hide their identity by removing any evidence of an attack and installing a backdoor for future access. To avoid any evidence that leads back to their malicious activity, hackers perform tasks that erase all traces of their actions. These include uninstalling scripts applications used to carry out attacks, modifying registry values, clearing logs, and deleting folders created during the attack. For those hackers looking to maintain undetected access, they tend to hide their identity using techniques such as tunneling or steganography. Having successfully performed all the 5 steps of ethical hacking, the ethical hacker then concludes the steps of ethical hacking by documenting a report on the vulnerabilities and suggesting remediation advice. Crashtest Security offers a comprehensive suite of testing tools that help you identify threats within your application. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security Channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.